Hey there, welcome back my YouTube family. Today we are diving into the world of data with a step-by-step guide on building a killer sales dashboard for a coffee chain. But before we jump into the action, make sure you check out the Epsom dashboards I have on the screen right now. Up the top, we have got a quick overview of sales quantity, sales amount, and monthly average sales and daily average sales. More, we have got the breakdown of location-wise, month-wise, day-wise, product-wise, product category-wise, day-by-day sales. More, I can select this focus mode. Basically, here I'm having month-by-month sales, their respective sales margin from the total sales. For example, in month number 4, I'm having 119K sales, which is the 17% of the total sales. So basically, this is the sales margin. In this chart, we are having this forecasting line, and the forecasting number is 23,000, means the sales must be more than 23,000 each day. Even I can slice data from this chart. More, if I have to slice this dashboard with reference to this coffee, I will click on it. So this dashboard is sliced with reference to this product category. So basically, this was the introduction of this powerful Power BI dashboard. Now we will start creating this whole dashboard. So first of all, I'm going to open Power BI. So now I'm going to select this new. So first of all, I'm going to press Ctrl S from my keyboard, selecting this more options, selecting this browse this device. This is my coffee sales dashboard, and I'm going to save this. So first of all, I'm going to select this import data from Excel. This is my data, coffee shop sales. I'm going to select this transaction table. So I'm pressing this load. So now my data has been uploaded successfully. Now I'm going to select this table view. In table view, I'm going to select this new table. This is my calendar is equal to calendar auto. Enter. So now I'm going to select this new column, and I have to extract the year from the date. So year is the DAX, calendar, date, enter. Again, I'm selecting this new column. Now I have to extract the month number is equal to month, and I will be selecting this date, enter. So now again, I have to select this new column, and here I will be typing month, year is equal to format, calendar, date, and the formatting 3 times month and 2 times Y. Again, I'm selecting this new column, quarter is equal to quarter. Okay, again selecting this new column, day number is equal to day, calendar, date, parenthesis close, enter. And at the last, I have to extract the day name is equal to format, calendar, date, and the formatting of the day will be 3 times D. So this calendar part is done. Now I'm selecting this model view, and here this transaction date will be connected to this date. So I'm dragging this date to this transaction date. So now these both tables are connected with reference to this one mean one and static mean many. So there is one to many relationship in these both tables. If you want to learn the one to many relationship in details, then you must watch this complete episode where I have explained each and everything about one to many relationship. So moving back to this report view, this first option, and now under home, I'm selecting this enter data. This is my calculations load. In this calculation table, I will be making the DAX formulas that I will be using during this whole dashboard. So here I'm clicking on this more option, new year, and the first DAX calculation, that is the sales amount, is equal to sum X. The first argument is required the table name. So my data is in transactions is the name of the table, and in transactions I have to multiply this transaction quantity with this transaction unit price. The multiplication of these both columns will give me the total amount of sales. So I'm clicking OK, and here I will be selecting this comma and make this decimal to 0. So again, I'm selecting this more options and this new year. Here I will be calculating my sales quantity is equal to sum of transactions, this transaction quantity, and here I will be selecting this comma and set this decimal to 0. So now again I'm selecting this Neumayer, and here I will be calculating the sales margin is equal to, so here I will be dividing my this sales amount with the calculations of this sale amount, but you have to remove the all filter with reference to this calendar month. So basically divide is a DAX function that calculates the ratio. So here we have calculated the ratio of this sales and this sales. This sales will give us the month by month sales. On the other hand, this calculate and all function sales will give us the grand sales, ignoring the filter of month. So when you will divide the monthly sales with the grand sales, obviously this will give you the percentage of each month with reference to the total sales. I'm selecting this more option and selecting this new year, and here I will be calculating the daily average sales is equal to. So first of all, I will be calculating the total number of days. So for this, this is my variable, and in this variable of days I will be storing my days is equal to distinct count transaction. In transaction I need the distinct count of the dates, parenthesis close, and here I will be typing this return, and here I will be dividing my total sales. So my total sales are total this sales amount, and I will be dividing this with the days. Press enter, the average monthly sales. But for this, first of all I will be selecting this table view, and from here I will be selecting my this transaction, and in transaction table I will be adding a new column with the name of month is equal to month transaction, this transaction date, and I will abstract number of month from my this date. Enter, and again I'm visiting my this report view, and here I will be selecting this new year. Month average sales is equal to, first of all I will be storing the number of months in my this variable. So the distinct count in my transaction, I have to calculate the distinct count of my months. Return, and I will be dividing this sales amount with my this month. So now I'm visiting this view section, and under view section I will be selecting this classic. Under this format your report page, this is my canvas background, and I'm selecting this 20% darker, and set this transparency to 2, and set this transparency to 50%. Now I'm visiting this insert, and here I'm selecting this shape. Now I'm going this shape, under shape this is style. In style I'm setting this color to white, and setting this border to off. Now again I'm selecting this shape, copy, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, dragging it here. Under this shape, this is style, and I'm setting the color to this one. I'm selecting this shape, Ctrl C, Ctrl V. So now I'm selecting this one, and I'm selecting this color. Again I'm selecting all of these my rest shapes. Under this shape, style, and I'm selecting this color. Then I'm visiting this format from this align, align top, and this distribute horizontally. Now I'm going to select this card, and from here I will be selecting this sales quantity. And I'm visiting this format here visual, this callout value, and this color to white, making it bold, and this category label, this one, and making it bold. In callout value, value decimal places set to 0, and from here I will be selecting this 1000 under this display unit. Now I'm copying this one, pasting it here. I'm making 4 copies of it. Now selecting this one, and I will remove this sales quantity to this sales amount, selecting this one. This is my monthly average. At the last, this is my daily average sales. So my this KPI section is ready. Now I'm going to this insert, and this is my text box, and here I will be typing This is my coffee sales dashboard. My this tree map. And here I will be selecting my this sales amount, and the segregation of the sales amount will be on the basis of this store location. So now I'm visiting my this format your visual, and under this visual I'm selecting this data label on and this display unit to 1000, setting this value decimal places to 0. Now going to this journal, this is my title, and the background of the title will be black, the text color to white, and making it center align, I'm making it 12 and making it bold. And under this journal I'm selecting this effect, and I'm selecting this background, selecting this 20% decline and setting it transparency to 50%, that is already 50%. Then again I'm selecting my this line and clustered column chart, and I will be selecting this sales amount to my this y-axis and this sales margin to this line y-axis, and I'm visiting this calendar, and I will be selecting this month number to x-axis. So now I'm going to this format your visual, and here I will be selecting this data label, making it on. Under my this data label, first of all I'm selecting this sales amount, and after going to this value and make this value bold, and display unit 2000 and make the decimal to 0 more. Again, I'm going back here, and here I will be selecting this sales margin, and now under this value, I'm selecting this auto and the decimal value to 0, this sales margin, and selecting this percentage. Then I'm going to this journal, this is my title, make it center align, background color to black, text color to white, and the size will be 12, make it bold. So basically these are my sales, 82,000, 76,000, 99,000, and this 12%, 11% and 14%, this is the percentage margin of the sales with reference to the total sales. So basically we are having the total sales of 699,000, and the sales of the January is 12% of the total sales, means this is the 12% of this 699,000. Hope so now you understand the concept of this sales margin. So now again I'm going to this format your visual. Now I'm going to this y-axis, I will make off these values. More, I will be visiting this journal, and under effect I'm making on this background and making it to this 10% darker. Transparency is already 50%. So now I'm going to click this one, copy, and control V, paste. So first of all I'm going to select this line chart. When I will select it, it will replace it to that specific chart, and now I'm going to remove this sales margin, and I will replace this month number with my day name. More, I'm visiting my this format your visual, and in this data labels I'm going to my value, and here I will set the decimal to 0. So now this is showing me my sales on the basis of days. On Monday we are having more sales, on Friday less than Monday. So basically we are having more sales on Monday, Friday and Thursday. So now I'm going to copy this, control V, and I'm going to select my this clustered bar chart, and here I will replace this store location visiting this transaction, this product detail, I'm copying pasting it again, and here I will replace this product detail with my this product category, and now I'm going to copy my this sales amount by day name, pasting it here, and here I will replace this day name with my visiting this calendar and this day name. I will put this day name to my this x-axis, and I'm visiting this format your visual, under visual x-axis, and here I will be selecting this categorical, and I will be selecting this sort axis to day number, and again sort axis, and here I will be selecting this sort ascending. So now it will showing me my sales day wise from 1st to 30. So now I'm selecting my this chart, and I'm going to this add further analysis, and here I will be selecting this average line, add line, and I'm making on the data label of this line. I will make the color to black and this display unit to 1000 and decimal set to 0. So the average sale is 23,000 for one day. Means if the sales is more than 23,000, that's mean this is okay. And if the sales are less than 23, that's mean there will be a problem. So similarly, I will be selecting this one and I'm adding this average line. Same, you have to visit this add further analysis, and here you will find this average line and you need to add it, and then I will be moving to this data label and I will make this color to black and display unit set to 1000 and the decimal set to 0. If the sales are more than 1 lakh means okay, and if the sales are less than 1 lakh means there is a problem. Now look, if I will click on it, it is not slicing the rest dashboard properly. So that's why I'm going to connect all these charts with each other. So that's why I'm selecting this one and I visited this format and I enable this edit interactions, and now I have to click this filter, this one, this one, this one, and this one. So now if I will click on it, it will slice the data with reference to this specific store location. If I have to see the data with reference to this one, it will slice the data with reference to this location. So similarly, now I'm selecting this one and I will apply the filter on rest charts. Similarly, I'm selecting this my third chart and selecting this filter from all the charts. Now I'm selecting this one. Now selecting this one. And now selecting the last one. And disable this edit interactions. So now if I will be selecting this month number 6, it will slice the rest dashboard with reference to month number 6. Now I'm going to select this insert. I'm selecting this image. I'm selecting all of these images one by one. I'm selecting all of my these images and I'm going to this journal properties and make it 80 by 80. I'm selecting all and making it size to, making the size to 90 to 90. So now at the end, I have to upload my this dashboard to the Power BI portal. So for this, I will be visiting this home, and under home, this is my publish. Save, select, got it, and now I'm going to visit, this is my Power BI portal, and here I will be visiting coffee sales dashboard. So if I will click on it, and here on view, I'm selecting this full screen. So finally, my this amazing Power BI dashboard is live and this is ready to present.